We are gathered here today in the sight of God in the presence of friends and loved ones to celebrate one of life's greatest moments. We are here to give recognition to the worthy and the beauty of love and to add our best wishes and blessings to the words that will unite TD and Kate in holy matrimony. Who gives this woman to be married?
Her mother and I.
TD and Kate, marriage is the most important of all earthly relationships. It should be entered into reverently, prayerfully, and with full of understanding of its sacred nature. Your marriage must stand by the strength of your love and the power of faith in each other in Jesus Christ. Just as two threads roving in opposite directions from a beautiful tapestry, so too your two lives, when merged together, will make a beautiful marriage. Paul gives an outline of what marriage is all about in Ephesians chapter 5. Kate says this, "Wives, be subject to your own husbands as service to the Lord. For the husband is the head of the wife, as Christ is the head of the church, himself being the Savior of the body. But as the church is subject to Christ, so also wives should be subject to their husbands in everything, respecting both their position as protector and their responsibility to God as head of the house." TD, husbands, love your wives, seek the highest good for her, and surround her with caring, unselfish love, just as Christ also loved the church and gave himself up for her, so that he might sanctify the church, having cleansed her by the washing of the water with the word of God, so that in turn he might present the church to himself in glorious splendor, without spot or wrinkle or any such thing, that she would be holy, set apart for God, and blameless. Even so, husbands should and are morally obligated to love their own wives as being in a sense of their own bodies. He who loves his own wife loves himself. For no one ever hated his own body, but instead nourishes and protects and cherishes it, just as Christ does the church. Because we are members part of his body. For this reason, man shall leave his father and mother and shall be joined and be fully devoted to his wife, and the two shall become one flesh. TDK, your marriage is a picture of the relationship between Christ and his bride, which is the church. You guys are a picture of that. Are you ready for the vows? All right. I, TD, take you, Kate.
Take you, Kate.
To be my wife.
Be my wife.
My partner in life.
My partner in life.
And in service to the Lord Jesus.
Service to the Lord Jesus.
I will cherish our friendship.
I will cherish our friendship.
I will love you unconditionally.
I will love you unconditionally.
Today.
Today.
Tomorrow.
Tomorrow.
And forever.
Forever.
I will trust you and honor you.
I will trust you and honor you.
I will laugh with you and cry with you.
I will laugh with you and cry with you.
I will love you faithfully.
I will love you faithfully.
Do the best and the worst.
Do the best and the worst.
Do the difficult and the easy.
Do the difficult and the easy.
Whatever may come.
Whatever may come.
I will be there.
I will be there.
As I have given you my hand.
As I have given you my hand.
So I give you my life to keep.
So I give you my life to keep.
So help me God.
So help me God.
Kate. I, Kate.
I, Kate.
Take UTD.
Take UTD.
To be my husband.
To be my husband.
My partner in life.
My partner.
And in service to the Lord Jesus.
And in service to the Lord Jesus.
I will cherish our friendship.
I will cherish our friendship.
Love you unconditionally.
Unconditionally.
Today.
Today.
Tomorrow. And forever. I will trust you and honor you.
I will trust you and honor you.
I will laugh with you and cry with you.
I will laugh with you and cry with you.
I will love you faithfully.
I will love you faithfully.
Do the best.
Do the best.
And the worst.
Do
the difficult.
Do the difficult.
And the easy.
And the easy.
Whatever may come.
Whatever may come.
I will always be there.
I will always be there.
As I have given you my hand.
As I have given you my hand.
So I give you my life to keep.
So I give you my life to keep.
So help me God.
So help me God.
Diddy, do you take Kate to be your wife? Do you promise to love, honor, cherish, and protect her? Protect her. Forsaking all others and holding only unto her forevermore.
I do.
Kate, do you take TD to be your husband?
I do.
Do you promise to love, honor, cherish, and protect her? Him.
I do.
Forsaking all others and holding unto him forevermore.
I do.
The ring. The ring is a symbol of broken circle of love. Love that is unconditionally given, has no beginning and no end. No giver and no receiver. For each is the giver and each is the receiver. May these rings remind you of the love, the vow that you have taken. ITD,
take
DK to be my wife,
to
have and to hold,
in
sickness and in health,
for richer or for poorer,
in joy and sorrow,
and
I promise
my
unconditional love to you, and with this ring,
I take you as my wife,
for as long as we both shall live. I, Kate.
I, Kate.
Take DTD.
Take DTD.
To be my husband.
To be my husband.
To have and to hold.
To have and to hold.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
For richer or for poorer.
For richer or for poorer.
In joy and sorrow.
In joy and sorrow.
And I promise.
And I promise.
My unconditional love to you.
My unconditional love to you.
And with this ring.
And with this ring.
I take you as my husband.
I take you as my husband.
For as long as we both shall live. Join with me in a wedding prayer. Bless their marriage, O God, as they begin their journey down the road of life together. We don't know what lies ahead, for the road turns and bends, but help them to trust you whatever may come their way, and to serve and trust you all the days of their life. Help them to continue to enjoy each other as they did when they first met. Help them to realize that nothing nor no one is perfect, and to look for good in all things and all people, including themselves and in each other. Help them to respect each other's likes and dislikes, opinions and beliefs, hopes and dreams, and fears, even though they may not always understand them. Help them to learn from each other and to help them to grow mentally, emotionally, and spiritually. Help them to realize that no matter what happens to them, they will hold on to each other and you, knowing that you have a way of working things out for the good. and help them to create for them children a peaceful, stable home of love as a foundation on which they can build their lives. My Father God, as we pray, may you do in them and through them all above all that we ask, seek, or pray. And it's in the name of Christ Jesus we pray. Amen. Together, this relationship will work. But it will take unconditional love for one another and a trust in the Lordship of Jesus Christ in your marriage. This is the core of your marriage, and that's why you are here today. It will take trust to know that in your hearts that you truly want best for each other. It will take dedication to stay open to one another and to learn and grow together. It will take faith to go forward together without knowing exactly what the future brings. And it will take commitment to hold to the true journey you both have pledged today with one another and to the Lord Jesus Christ. Katie and Kate. Have a compass. As you start out on a journey and you don't know where you're at and where you're going, this compass will get you to where you need to be if you know where you're supposed to end up. It will get you there. And as you start this journey together in life, there's going to be many detours. There's going to be many roads that you're going to take. There's going to be things that's going to come up out of the blue. But if you guys will trust in the Lord Jesus Christ, put him at the head, trust in the Word of God, and together, holding this compass, holding the Word of God together, God will get you guys to where he wants you to be. And you will have a successful, godly marriage in all that you guys do. Always put God first, together, and together help each other to grow and to follow the Lord. And God will not fail you guys. I promise you that. Did he? Some 29 years ago, Brother C.L. Lindsay, who married your mom and I, he looked at me and he said, David, Lisa's taking your last name. Don't ever do anything to make her ashamed to carry that last name. Today, Kate is willing to take the last name of Sosworth. Don't ever do anything in life that will make her ashamed to carry the name of Sosworth. Make that promise. By the power invested in me, I now pronounce you husband and wife. You may kiss the bride. My dear friends and family, for the very first time, it is my joy and my privilege to announce to you Mr. and Mrs. T.D. Sizemore. Woo!